Hey guys, let me share with you our research that we made for building a recommendation system by using our existing models that we already have in our organization. So let's start. A little bit about myself. I'm currently a director, working as director of data science at First Digital Bank. It's a new bank in Israel that maybe you are going to hear about in the near future. Little bit about myself. I have 10 years of experience in building various types of systems, machine learning, deep learning, recommendation systems, big data, and AI. So little bit about the agenda here in our talk. First of all, maybe you heard about Shap before in the past, but we will talk about the different types of application, different types of use cases that we are using Shap in our system, in other types of usages, in different type of systems today. After it, we'll talk about a little bit about the concept, the theory behind Shap, and of course, game theory. Little bit a deep dive for Shap, and then we will see how we can what is the architecture that the right architecture for this type of applications for building a recommendation system by using Shap. We will see different types of competitors and advantages that Shap has comparing to other solutions that you may use in different types of systems. And in the end, a little bit short demo how to use it. So let's start. A little bit about the Shap applications or why we are going to use it. Today, Shap is mainly used for explainable models, to explain the models, the predictions that our machine learning models give. For example, in SageMaker, AWS SageMaker, they are using Shap to explain the predictions as a debugger tool for the models that are built by using this platform. So the main usage today for Shap is to explain our predictions, to explain, for example, around the forest model, to explain the threat, explain the predict that was made by the model. And our research is, we thought how to use this kind of system, this kind of technology to help us build the recommendation system by using our existing models. For example, models that we had in the world of advertisement, click-through rate that predicts the possibility of a click on an ad or on our advertisement solutions. So the goal was to build recommendation systems for campaigns, for advertisement campaigns, to recommend on the right preferences of a campaign, of a future campaign. So we had different kind of models like CTR, click-through rate, viability of models, and so on. And we thought how we can use it with Shap for building a recommendation system for our new customers to build new campaigns. So before we are jumping to our solution, a little bit about game theory and Shap. So here in the example, there is Alice, Bob, and Celine that is going to share a meal in a restaurant. And they every time we have in the history of those three persons, we have the history of the meals and how much they paid for every meal. When Alice got went alone to a restaurant and eat for $80, or Bob that went and eat in $56, and so on. So and the, of course the combinations. The great stuff here is that we are going to see all. We are going to use all those kind of permutations from the history, and replace every time the order and usage of the historical data to build all the permutations, all the possible permutations from the history. You can see it in the right. Sometimes we can use, if it's ABC, Alice, Bob, and Celine. So we first of all take the historical row of Alice that spent $80 in the restaurant, and the last one, A, B, and C. And we will see that, and of course, A, B with $80 and A, B, C with $90. So in the first row in the right side, you can see it's 80. For Bob, it's zero because they have a row that tells us that A and B also spent together 80. And the $10 left is to get to 90 as the last row in the historical data. So we are doing all the possible permutation from the historical data, replacing every time one of the features, one of the spent of every person in the restaurant by the historical data. And in the end, we're doing like an average to calculate the Shap value, the Shapley value of every feature here. Every feature here is the how much person spent in the restaurant. So in the end, after doing an average for every person, we are getting the Shap value for every person that's going to represent the amount of money they are going to maybe spend in the future if they are going to go together to the restaurant in the future. So at the last line here in the red and blue is to say, okay, they are going to maybe spend like $24 in the future if they are going to go together. But every behavior of a person can change the results of this kind of prediction. So we are getting not only the feature importance, but also the value importance of this kind of play, this kind of a game with all the players in the restaurant. So with Shap, we can, comparing to other solutions to explain the models, for example, feature importance in the XGBoost model API, we are getting here not only the feature importance, how much is important every feature, for example, the age of the age of Bob and Alice, or if Bob or if Bob and Alice went to a restaurant without Celine, something like that. So we are not getting also this, but also the values. How much is important that Alice came and how much she spent. And from this, we can understand the explanation, to explain the future prediction, also if it didn't happen in the past. So in Shap, we are from the other under the scenes, we are trying to replace every value, every attribute for every feature, every time in our Shapley values calculation, and try to find. We are trying to change one attribute in one feature and try to understand the importance and value importance of this prediction. So we are not predicting only. We are not predicting only the past, based on the past, we are going to get in the future possibilities that combinations of features that maybe didn't happen in the past. It's very important for recommendation systems, not only to be based on the past, but also try to estimate the importance and maybe the help of new combinations and maybe recommend on new combinations of features that maybe not happened in the past, but it's possible, they possible for them to happen. And we have enough information to estimate how this change going to affect all the society of features, all the combinations of features. So a little bit about the types of architectures for using Shap. So we need to pass, when we are building a model, we are preparing the data set for the model, and of course doing the training, validation, and so on, and doing the predictions. So for explaining the model, for explaining the predictions of a model, we are supposed to pass to Shap the data, the train data that we based on for training the model, and the model itself. By passing those two types of data and model, we are calculating all the Shapley values, all the features in the model, and can of course explain the predictions that we did with the model. So the output is going to be the feature importance and the attribute importance of every prediction. Every attribute is going to not only understand how much it's important, it's for better or the worse, to understand how much it affects this, for example, how much this feature got us to bad results for a specific campaign, or how much it helped us to improve the results of a specific campaign. So we can, for example, after calculating all the Shapley values, we can build a service, an endpoint for explaining our predictions, or using our model and data to build a service for our recommendation system to recommend on the right features and right attributes for a specific campaign. We can filter out the preferences of the campaign. For example, if a customer tells us that he wants to advertise in California for specific hours a day in specific publishers, we can suggest him all the other preferences that's going to help him get better results in his campaign. For example, suggest him on a specific demographics of customers and specific custom demographics that can help him to get better results by using his past data. We are doing predictions. We are training on his past campaigns, and we are learning from all the combinations in the past, exactly that we did with Alice and Bob. And right now we are trying to predict, not only to predict all the combinations that we had in the past, but also Shap is going to help us to find the best combination that also that didn't happen in the past, and we can now recommend for the campaign manager to target and create those type of combinations in the future. So we are starting to build recommendation systems by using Shap, our existing model and existing train data. We have been familiar with different types of solution to calculate the info gain, to calculate the feature importance, like I said before, the LGBoost info gain API, and also there's another open source project named Line for explaining models. The big advantages of Shap is the consistency in the results and the accuracy of the results. It's much less can be affected by quick changes in the model, by the changes of the values in the model. It's very consistent with its results. We can talk about it more than an hour to explain why, but there are different, I also added here different type of papers that explain exactly this issue. So another main advantage for Shap is that it supports different type of models, also deep learning models, chaos models, XGBoost models, and scikit-learn. So here we have like a quick demo of the code that help us to create in very few lines of code all the Shapley values that we talked about. We first of all filtered out all the historical data of a specific campaign, specific customer from all his past campaigns. We filtered the data, trained a model on this data, sent the data and the trained model to Shap, created in Shap Shapley values for all of its historical data, and created all types of combinations, also for combinations of features and values that did happened in the past data, but happened in different types of rows in the historical data. So after it, we filtered out all the combinations that is going to improve the results. It's going to improve the results, for example, of click-through rate, to get a higher percentage of clicks compared to impressions, by sending the most important and improving features and combinations of features, not only specific features, that it's more popular, for example, in BI, in business intelligence, to build a graph on a specific on specific features with all its values and say, okay, for this type of values, it's going to help us to improve the results of the campaign. Here we are recommending on combinations of features, and those type of combinations is going to be very targeted combinations, very valuable, and much more accurate than recommend on specific value for a specific feature. So this is the main advantage of Shap, how we can use it for building not also tools for explaining models, but also recommendation systems by using our existing models. So here it's like the GitHub for Shap. It's open source, we can use it. And two other examples of papers and blog posts that talks about different types of usages for Shap. For example, explaining and recommending for a bank which credit score to give a specific customer and how to explain it for the customer, why he got this kind of a credit score. And it can help us a lot, maybe also today when I'm working, managing the data science group in our Israel bank. So I think here we talked about, it's like short talk, but I think that we covered the possibilities of using Shap in different kinds of use cases, from explaining models, for building recommendation systems. And I hope that it will help you to test your existing models, to think how you can build for your customers recommendation systems that can help them managing and improving their results. So that's all. Happy to get the feedback. Thank you, guys.